My name is Ravinder. I'm founder for Pure Data Labs. This is a venture which I started 6 months back. So the company solves the discovery and retention problem for small and medium businesses by providing easy to use. We solve the discovery and retention problem for small and medium businesses by giving them data driven actions which just works for them. They do the sales. So before I get into this, I'll just talk about the problem from an example. Because today all of us go to various stores. It could be Amazon, it could be Flipkart. We go online and we try to buy something from there. These people start, they know that you came and they have your purchase history, they have your personal information. They use all that to engage you in various means. Which basically turns into retaining the customers back, like they keep on engaging you with new offers or with your card being empty, etc. And which leads to you going back to them to do the sales. Fure wants to be the company who allows every store, you know, small businesses, medium businesses, do exactly that. So if I go to a saloon could very well say, hey Ravinder, you came 1 month back, now it's time for you to have a haircut, why don't you come back, right? Or if I go to a place to get my car serviced, they could do the very same thing. So the tech, we want to have the same technology with everyone, not just with people. So that's what Fure wants to do. The solution is simple. We need a way for these guys to be able to have data-driven decision and engagement. Having said that, yes, it's easy to say that. A lot of people have tried doing this, and most of them, if you see today, there are a lot of companies who build tools to allow all this to happen. Example could be Mobicom or it could be Investo. So what all of them have done is very same thing. They give you a tool which you can run yourself and do all the kind of engagement. Unfortunately, the small and medium businesses we are talking about, they can't do this. They're not tech savvy. They don't understand all of that. What they need is a solution which just fits there. Maybe have a small initial setup and it just starts working for them. If there is something like that, that will work out. Otherwise, it will not. I'm saying this because even though we are just there for 6 months, there have been places where I was pitching right next to a guy who came from Mobicom, and we were able to win against them simply because I tell them that, you know, there's nothing you have to do. Just put it there and it starts working. So, coming to the first part of solution, the engagement part is already there. We have 26 clients who are already using this in Vijayanagar. Another problem which I talked about is the problem of discovery. How do we solve the discovery problem for these customers, right? So there what we do is, today we allow them to convert in-store engagement into social engagement. Not in a very nice way, but it's kind of working. So whoever comes in-store, our system allows them to send messages based on their past history. It allows them, hey, you have been coming here often. Would you mind reviewing us on Facebook and we'll give you some offer, right? And we have seen tremendous results just from this. And this improved social presence leads to more people coming back. Why now? Earlier maybe the internet was not there anymore, right? So maybe the people going to small businesses, all of them didn't have the smartphone in their pocket, right? But not anymore. Everybody has access to internet all the time. Everybody can take part in this whole engagement retention cycle. At the same time, if you go to Google Trends and you see people searching for businesses near me, you will find a very large increase in the last 2 years, 5 years, which basically means that people are looking for businesses near them. There are not enough ways to find them. Market size. Cool. So Fure wants to be the engagement medium for everyone. Today we are specifically focusing on saloons, spas, eateries, restaurants, pubs, etc. But having said that, really I want Fure to be with everybody, you know, your carpenter, electrician, everybody could have the same technology to engage their customer or get discovered. Just to put the numbers here, Urban Clap has 65,000 listings of various professionals on their platform. And Paytm has 3 million offline merchants. Anybody who is using Paytm for payments could very well use a simple tech to engage their private customers. Competition. So, there is people like Mobicom, there are people like Investo who are doing it for 10 years, 9 years, and they are pretty much the direct competitors. But as I said, they have pretty much focused on building a good tool. which also works very well for enterprise, but somehow it is not done well for a small and medium business. Apart from that, there are various indirect competitions. For example, various POS. Various POS also allow sending out personalized messages. But then they are very limited in the capabilities. Mostly they will talk about sending out a lot of SMS to all of them. Product. So today the product consists of a dashboard which can be used to configure and see the analytics. So you configure the initial setup and then you see the results there. That's what it is for. Apart from that, there are two Android apps. The Android app is used, one of them can be used to capture data from people, taking feedback, etc. Another app is for the store owner who uses it to get instant notifications or maybe changing the settings, etc. Business model. How do we make money today? Cool. So it's been running for 6 months. Initially, because I didn't have enough money to do all this, we started off with a 600 rupees per month plan. Today also that's the case. 26 paying clients, all of them pay us between 600 to 100 rupees per month. Having said that, that's not the business model I want to go forward with, because I believe the money is there in the data. So what we want to do is we want to have offline data of everybody going everywhere. So if I just quickly compare it with what Google does today, if you go to website, Google has data about I'm visiting this website and how frequently. That's all the data they have. Right? Anything else, what I'm doing on the website is immaterial. Similarly, where I'm going to the offline store and how often I'm going, this data, if I have for everybody, can be used to target ads much better in Google, because even today, most of the businesses, most of the sales happens on offline. Right? So we want a business model where this engagement platform is free for everyone, anybody can just click it and start using it. All we need is the engagement platform only works when you recall the data of people coming to you and where the same data comes back to us, and we use it in an aggregate manner to use the data to do a lot of things, right? Target ads, or it could be used to show hyperlocal sponsored content when people say any business near me, well, we could use to show them. Team. So right now we are a team of 10. There are 6 people working on what all I just said. I also have 4 people doing services, because if you see, our team consists of people who have expertise around digital marketing, right? So those 4 guys also do services for various clients. We count people like Savari, Fresher World across for our clients in the services domain as well. And even though that's not a long-term strategy at all, but for now, that helps us make money so that we can keep. Financials. So far this we have spent almost 10.5. This is the money that I made. It includes both the money from the product I talked about, also from the services. 2.8, that's what I learned today. Yeah, that's pretty much how it is. Anupai has recently invested with us. He stands at 10% discount on conversion. He invested 15 lakh. I'm looking for raising 16 lakh rupees. 60 lakh rupees will give me a cushion of running this whole thing for 12 months at a burn rate of 60 lakh rupees per month. And the extra money lets me get engineers and people to build an awesome product, because all this could be a good idea, but unless I have very good people working on that, at some point of time it will fail. And good people need money. This is mostly to get the people to work on the product and marketing. This is going to, of course, help drive the sales faster by probably giving 1 month of free trial, and then you can see if you want to continue or something. I didn't know, but I just copied the same slide. I thought it's easy. Yeah, thank you so much. This is all from my side. I do have some snapshots as well, but I think I'm running out of time.
Google doesn't have much, so what is exactly the goal of the website? I'm not sure if you really aware of that, but I have analytics, which actually looks into the particular page, how much time you spend, which were you looking for, what was the development you thought about that?
Absolutely, no. So, man, I was saying that, yeah, but Google does all that for B2B. So, if I'm talking about a small problem, so they don't really have a website. How do they get advantage from that?
His reference from that point was from an offline activity he can capture.
Offline, he's generally giving offline solution.
Actually capturing for a consumer. It's more a consumer data for other transactions done in the offline mode.
So for me, the transactions matter, right? So who today the
you are giving that app to the owner.
Today that's the case, right? So today we allow them to send messages to their customers, right? So today we have integrated just the SMS. Going forward, we want to integrate other messaging services. Let's say Messenger or Hike.
You maybe also have a dashboard. That
yes, we have a dashboard which they can
you
use.
You have a screenshot of it. You want to put it up so that. So it's for a merchant. He gives their customer data like how a Google Analytics would do online user data.
Yeah, for a merchant, you know, they could see on a single case by case. If I go to a merchant, they could see that this guy is enrolled in a referral program. And again, all these modules, you could see that the guy came last time on this date and he gave me this feedback.
This is a walk-in customer to a retail store, yes. Like how you would have done online what Google does. So I think what he mentioned was a little wrong, but the context is in this.
He's capturing the data.
Yes. So
he's making it digitally available for them.
Yes. So that they can use the data later to engage their customers. Right? So why they will do that is that
actionable data.
Yes. And why I am doing it because if I get the data of everybody in the number, then it's a data which can be used to make a lot of money.
And the way you collect the data, how do you collect the data? It's on the bill. Is that the point of?
So today there are two ways. One, we have given them an app. Sorry, this is the first.
See, they have a consumer app as well. So one is a user app, other one is a merchant app.
So
merchant
this app
is the dashboard.
If they don't want this app, the dashboard also has. Let's say I'm sitting in a saloon, right, and somebody walks in. Well, I have a dashboard where I could just put his number, and I don't need the person to use the app or whatever. So there are various means because the industry, the whole thing I'm looking for is very fragmented, right? A small grocery guy may not have a name of app, right? So he needs a. So on the mobile, there is. He just opens it, the first screen says put the number, he puts the number and the detail of the guy shows up. You know, he has come here before, last time he came. He is part of a loyalty program, he is part of a referral and you could quickly take actions from there. And as I said, for that guy, for him it's very simple. When I go to a sales pitch, you put his number, a lot of things will come. If you are interested in loyalty, other things will follow.
You could probably talk about a specific customer case would help. You have the question, I think, different from this.
Yeah.
Do you have any data of sales acceleration of any of your customers?
Yes. So, I give you a few data. One of them is,
I have a lamp manufacturing company. Okay. We service both B2B and B2C. How can it service?
I'm sorry, I didn't understand the business. Can you tell me
lamp manufacturing?
Okay.
So, have a lamp manufacturing company. These are two large companies.
So, if you have a way to talk to your end customer, I don't know because we are.
See, right now he is catering to the retailer.
Okay, absolutely.
Where selling
something. Maybe for you, today we can't help because you don't sit at the point where the sale happens. Right? This is for everybody who sit at the point of sale.
Right? You say a hotel could be my.
Yes, a hotel could be a saloon, could be a gym, spa, eatery, grocery, right? Anywhere where I go and buy. Where we allow
the consumer touch point. Your touch point would be a retailer for you. For him, a retailer to a consumer is where he is playing right now.
This is more
B2B.
What
is the
customer engagement?
So, we allow them to very easily do things like running loyalty program, running referral program. They could send a specific kind of, for example, a pub could set up SMS. To be sent on Thursday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, based on the visit of the guy, right? So all of this, we set up once, you know. So every Thursday, all the people who visited in the last 5 days send this message, right? Simple engagement, right? A loyalty program where I go there, right? And the moment I walk in, they put my number, and I get a SMS saying, we have been here 5 times before, pay up for $2,000 and we give 20% back, right? So, and all this, as I said, all this works for him, just by putting my number on the dashboard. So I think the play is more around making it simple for them to use. Because there are people who are doing it for the capital, they have been doing this for years, right? But they target big enterprises. Right?
Last question.
Yes, we have one recommendation from your action system. You're not focused on the people getting the right thing, but also since you are using the data and using the data from these regulatory aspect.
I have to meet a lawyer first. I do agree with what you said. I need to meet a lawyer to understand what I can do and what I can't. So having said that, today, Fuway doesn't use the data by itself. I just use the data of the guy for him believe that's kind of fun. The day I want to start using it to do something by myself, I believe that day I will be trouble unless I find out what is needed. So far, we have not started. So in my case, the message comes saying, let me. Right? So you will get an SMS and...
Message is so many times,
saying
that they
may... No, I know.
We'll just get the next one. Just...
I'll be here, we can always. Okay guys, thank you. Thank you everyone.